Hello, Catherine here from BBC Learning English. Just so you know, this programme is from the BBC Learning English archive. It was originally broadcast in March 2006 on our website. Enjoy!
BBC
LearningEnglish.com.
Hello, I'm Callum Robertson and this is Weekender. This Sunday is a special day in Britain. It's not an official national holiday, and not everybody will be doing anything different, but it is marked in the diary. What day is it? It's Mother's Day, or Mothering Sunday. And in this programme, we'll find out about the origins of this special day for mothers.
BBC LearningEnglish.com.
Mothering Sunday is a day when people send cards, flowers, and other presents to their mothers. But what's its origin? Where does it come from? And why is it held on this particular day? I asked some of my colleagues if they knew.
No, I don't, actually. Can you tell me?
No, I have to be honest. I really don't. I just take it as a day of celebrating how great our mums are, but I really didn't think about where it came from.
I think it's something to do with Lent and Easter, but I can't remember what.
I'm afraid I don't know the origins of Mother's Day. I suspect it's probably something religious, but I don't actually know what it is.
Well, my understanding of it was that it was the day that all the girls in service were allowed to go home and see their mothers. And why it's on this day, I can't remember, but it might have something to do with Easter, but I don't know what the story is.
It seems as if most people are not too sure of the origins of Mothering Sunday, but they think it has something to do with the Christian religious period of Easter and the six-week period before that called Lent. But is that correct? To find out for sure, I spoke to Father Alistair Coles, who is the parish priest of St Mary's Church in Bourne Street in London. I asked him about the history of Mothering Sunday.
Goes back a long time, and there's one tradition that during medieval times people and clergy would travel to the mother church of the diocese, to the cathedral on this day, this coming Sunday. And there's probably good sense in that the worst of winter weather had gone by then. But none of that really helps with Mothering Sunday. The earliest reference to it comes in 1644 during the Civil War in this country. There's a royalist officer called Richard Simmons, who noted a custom in Worcester in the middle of Lent when children and godchildren would meet at the head and chief of the family and have a feast. And it was called Mothering Day. But all that's quite a long time ago, and by the last century, this custom had spread throughout the West Midlands and the Welsh borders, the southwest, and as far as far north as Lancashire. This is the beginning of the 20th century, late 19th century, I suppose. And apprentices and young servants were often released to go home and visit their families on this day.
So there was a tradition of families getting together in the Lent period or visiting their mother church or the big church or cathedral for their area. However, this is a very old tradition. By the end of the 19th century, it was common for wealthy families to have servants living in their homes, and on Mothering Sunday they were given a holiday and allowed to go home and visit their families. These days, though, this habit of having servants living in the houses of their employers has died out. So how has the tradition of Mothering Sunday continued? Well, according to Father Coles, with a little help from the United States.
By the 1930s, this sort of pattern of Mothering Day and of release from work for home visits, that was all nearly forgotten. Its revival was brought about by the determined efforts of a Miss Anna Jarvis of Philadelphia, whose guiding passion in her life was a devotion to her mother. Miss Jarvis was also well enough connected to turn her private obsession into public law. She badgered and harassed the government of the United States until it passed a law in 1913 that the second Sunday in May would be a national day of remembrance for mothers, Mother's Day. And the custom gradually spread back across the Atlantic. By post-war times was back in the popular awareness of the British, but on Mothering Sunday, this fourth Sunday of Lent.
So Mother's Day in the United States began in the 20th century after the efforts of one woman, Anna Jarvis. The influence of the United States came over the Atlantic, and in Britain we took the celebration and gift-giving, but on our original Mothering Sunday date during Lent, and not in May, which is when it's celebrated in the United States and in other countries. Well, that's all from this edition of Weekender. I'm off to buy a nice present for my mother.
BBC. LearningEnglish.com.